As schools finalize the final touches of reopening after a protracted COVID-19-induced lockdown, Kampala Capital City Authority has issued a warning to all schools daring to reopen this weekend for boarding students before the stipulated date of January 10th. This warning has been sounded by the Director of Education in KCCA, Juliet Namudu Nambi, while meeting head teachers of private schools in Makindye Division, and asked schools to send SMSs to their parents to observe government dates.
The Minister of Education and Sports took very seriously what His Excellency said. He said schools will start on which date? The 10th. So on the 10th, all day scholars in the whole country and in the greater Kampala metropolitan area will report to school. Are we together? All day scholars. Now, in Kampala, on Tuesday the 11th of January, the A-level boarding students and the lower primary school boarding student learners will come back to school. Lower primary comprises which classes? P1, P2, P3, P4.
Head teachers reported that although the reopening was announced for 10th January, many parents have started delivering their children to spend a weekend at school, which is giving them a difficult situation.
Head teacher, my child is ready and here. Yeah, ready for school. So as they announce that schools are to reopen and stagger, parents cannot get this information well. Yes. I'm very sure for all those that have children in boarding schools, come Monday, the director, the suitcases will be entering into the schools.
It is us as head teachers to give information to our dear parents so that there is that smooth reporting back to school. It will also help us in schools to receive children, you know, in bits, not to have that overflow.
Namudu has guided schools to stick to the staggered reopening program as was released by the Ministry of Education earlier this week to avoid violating the school reopening guidelines, which will land them in problems.
His Excellency the President of Uganda and Mama, the Minister of Education and Sports, guided that the greater Kampala metropolitan area arranges themselves in such a way that they stagger the return of boarding school learners in this new term for three reasons: to reduce on the congestion in the transport sector, to make sure that we follow the standard operating procedures.
She also prohibited schools from charging parents money for admission and interviews, saying they are not allowed in the new normal because all learners were given automatic promotion to next classes.
No learner should be subjected to promotion exams, and there shall be no beginning of term or mid-term examinations. Are we together? Have you started assessing them to promote them? They were automatically promoted. Please don't ask the parents for 20,000 shillings for admission fees. Are we together?
Although learners were given automatic promotion, schools are expected to compress syllabus of two classes and teach them at once in this academic year.
We are not saying now you go back and you start telling the children. We are going to start by learning P1 work, and then afterwards we shall learn P2 work. No. You're going to sit in your small groups and you're going to discover how to handle the content of the two classes concurrently. If you're teaching addition started when they were in primary. I told you, his parents said the child can count up to 200. Maybe they can even add. So what is the content they were supposed to cover in P1? What are they supposed to cover in P2? Merge the two.
KCCA has vowed to step up inspection of compliance to COVID-19 SOPs and not to let any unvaccinated staff in school premises.
You have the temperature guns. I know you have those, the water tanks, the washalots, the soap, you name it. But my message to all of you is that it should not be for one day. It should not be for a show.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.